world. The Seekers were mega big, and they stayed that way for hit after hit. They made a film in those days about the rapid rise of the other Fab Four with songs like Georgie Girl and The Carnival Is Over. And that film disappeared like the Seekers themselves, but now after a quarter of a century, it's been found.
It was 1967, and more than 200,000 people turned up to hear a folk band at Melbourne's Myer Music Bowl. The folk band was called The Seekers, and to this day, the concert remains the biggest ever live performance in the Southern Hemisphere.
There were so many people apart from us, even, in the fact there were 200,000 people here on the day we had our concert.
Well, it's a benchmark of our lives, not just our career.
In 1964, three clean-cut lads from Melbourne were looking for a lead singer for their folk group. Athol Guy found a likely candidate when 19-year-old Judith Durham joined his advertising company. They reenacted the moment years later.
Yes, I'm Judith Durham. Are you Athol Guy?
Yes, Judith Durham. They wasn't supposed to come and hear you sing sometime.
Yes, you were.
True, a true rendition of our first meeting, as Judith will confirm.
Well, he was so suave. I mean, I was sort of like, I was a jazz singer at night, and I was just, a secretary in the daytime. And, of course, Athol was one of the big account executives, and he seemed a very sophisticated person to me.
This train and bound for glory, this train. This train and bound for glory, this train.
At first, the Seekers played in smoky folk clubs until they boarded the Fair Sky and worked their way to Britain as the ship's dance band. As all fairy tales would have it, they were discovered, teamed up with songwriter Tom Springfield, and their first single made it to number one.
You ready? Right, let's make this the one.
I think really once we got over though, fame really took us by surprise because we were the first Australian group to ever go overseas and we were really going for a holiday, but of course when we got there we found work and suddenly we were number one in the charts all over the world.
And I'll be there someday if you will hold my hand.
In fact, in 1966, the Seekers outsold every other group worldwide, including the Beatles and the Rolling Stones.
For I know another you.
They made this film in 1968. Perhaps a little corny now, it swept all before it as Australia's highest rating special. It's now been released on video.
He's writing another song.
Shh. The goose may lay another golden egg.
The Seekers were together for only 4 years.
Look,
but what they created has proved timeless.
You know what I mean.
I get the most emotion from is The Carnival Is Over, and I felt that the very moment Tom Springfield sang it to us, it was very, very strong within me that we just had to do that song.
Along with the many triumphs, hardship as well. Judith Durham is battling a progressive respiratory disease, which has left her with only 40% lung capacity.
I'm certainly not trying to be a hero. I mean, I do deal with this illness on a daily basis, as all other lung disease sufferers do. Who knows, my life may not be very heroic in the end. I might suddenly have problems and that could be the end of me. My life was music, always, from when I was a very, very young child. So I was felt, in fact, I told my family I was going to be world famous one day. I mean, that was my vision and I've never stopped ever since. Obviously, I just...
And one day you will be.
But it was...
Stick with us and we'll make you a star. I told you that in 1963 when I had the shades on.
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
Yeah, I love Judy's voice.